let's start from the top. Jeff Smith here, Otter Creek Golf Course, Columbus, Indiana, plain and simple golf school for those weekend golf guys, and the $5golfclub.com. I wanted to talk today a little bit about practicing indoors. Here we are, end of October. Cold is setting in. People are getting a little bit miserable about, hey, no longer are we able to go out and play in the sun and all that. So let's start talking about what are we going to do this fall to keep ourselves going in golf? What are we going to do? How are we going to work our bodies? How are we going to work with things to know that we're going to continue to improve? Lots of you don't have a golf cave, but lots of you have a garage. And so what I'm going to suggest to you is that you make your own golf cave out of your garage for as little of money as possible. So what I'm going to suggest to you is thinking of this. You pull your car out of the garage, and then you have this big, gigantic space that you could use. Now, behind me, I've got a big old screen and all that that's going to stop my golf balls. But I'm going to suggest to you that you don't need that. I'm going to suggest to you that you hang a bed sheet from the garage door rails and you use golf balls that are foam so that you can keep hitting. And you turn it sideways and you got the garage door coming down behind you and the rails are up here and they're up here and you can get an old bed sheet and you can clip them up there with clothespins and you can hit foam golf balls. I'll show you. I've got some. You know, I got a few of these. And they don't cost much money. I think I went over to one of the big box cheap everything stores. And I went to their sporting goods section. And I think they had about 40 or 50 of these in a bucket. And I think it only cost like $6 or $7 or something. So I have some of these. And they're lightweight, they don't hurt anything, they bounce a little bit, you can squeeze them, you can hit them, we don't have to worry too much about where they go. I'm going to stand here, hit one, listen for the sound of it. So here I am bouncing them around the golf studio and I don't care, there's a TV over there. I just fired it right at it, don't care. They're so soft. Now granted, they don't provide you much feel in feedback. But when you're making full swings indoors, you're certainly far better off to do this than nothing. So I want to make sure that we set up a few things as cheap as you could possibly set it up. So I'm going to give you examples of what you could do. I want you to go to the store, home builder store, you know, one of the big box places, and go get two doormats. Get them, you know, the kind that are squishy and you wipe your feet off. They don't have to be nearly as thick as the mat that I'm on right now. They don't have to be that at all. Maybe they're a quarter inch to a half inch thick. Maybe they're as thick as an inch. Buy two of them the same height. And I want you to put them down on the ground, one where you'll put your feet on, and the other you'll put your club on. And then tape them down to the floor. Especially the one you're going to hit off of, but tape them down to the floor. Get some duct tape and put them on the floor and tape them down so that they won't move around, won't slide. Because you're going to be on them and your body's going to be pushing and twisting and do all that. We don't want our feet sliding around. And when we hit the golf ball, we don't want any of that either. So now you've got some place to hit. Now you've got foam balls to hit. And now you've got something to hit off of that's not going to damage you. So let's keep that in mind. You can build your own space. And then when you do, let's start talking about how do you get feedback. Okay. So let's figure out a couple of things. What could you do that you could easily put on the ground, on your mat, so that you know that your club was traveling through it? So you know that the swing direction at the bottom of your golf swing would be headed the direction you want. Well, got that right here. A couple of these alignment sticks, we all have them. As golfers, we know where to go get these. I got these at the big box store, you know, the home builders kind of place. But you know, I don't have to use the sticks, but I'm going to show you that right here. I'm going to put them on the ground. And I'm just going to stand here and see that my swing, at the bottom of my swing, my club is traveling in that direction. You know, and if I'm trying to change the direction of my swing at the bottom, I can just change the direction of these sticks, still stand straight, and do whatever it takes to feel where I'm trying to make these sticks go and make my arms go through. I want to feel that so I can see it and I can feel it. These are nice, but I don't have to spend any money on those, because if we've already got duct tape to put down on the, to put the mats down and hold those, I can use the same duct tape and make a couple of lines and swing between the duct tape. I want to make it so that you don't cost yourself a lot of money in this project. You don't need to. We're not here to cause you extra expense. We're trying to make it pretty simple to develop something that you could do as cheap as you can. Now, what I've done here, I took one of those foam golf balls that I have on these softies, and I drilled a little hole in it. I took one of those alignment sticks and I cut it, and I shoved it into the end of this, glued it in there so it wouldn't go anyplace. So what do I have? I got a golf ball on the end of an alignment rod, and I could just sit here and see a golf ball and drive it forward, and I have a really nice visual. I don't hit this. I don't want this thing splattering all over the place, but I get myself some visual aids. I can angle it any direction that I'm looking for. If I wanted to, I could put this in the middle of my stance, practicing ball position, because here's a line right on the ground that I know is right here over my, under my spine. So I can practice my setup. I could put that right here, and I could say, hey, I'm turned, and when I make a full turn, I'm right over that stick. I could use it for my driver ball position over here, where I could get it so everything lines up on the left shoulder. There's a lot of things that I can do, something like that. Cheap, easy. Here's another thing that I like a lot. So I got this stick, and you could tie this little ribbon on it, just a plastic ribbon. You know, and I like it, ribbon to be 3-4 feet. But this tells me a lot. It tells me where my swing is going, for sure. You know, when I take it back and swing, I just made a golf swing, and y'all could see that where the ribbon is, trail is going. And you know for sure, because you can see where your swing went, because it's a visual right in front of you. So I could swing it. If I'm this guy and I don't want to be that guy swinging down across it again, I'm going to change something to my setup a little bit. I'm going to raise the left shoulder, lower the right. I'm going to take the right elbow and move it down a little bit. Then I'm going to swing, and I'm going to have a whole different angle, and I'm going to change it. And it's really easy to do, because that's feedback. It's a pretty good deal. What I want to talk about now, other things that you can use to swing, to make sure that you have good practice habits at home. So let's think about stuff you could swing. Now here, I got a big gigantic stick, and it's kind of heavy. But you could use something like a piece of metal pipe that you could go get at one of the big box stores that's heavy just to loosen up with. You can put something on the end. These happen to have very oversized grips on them in the end, but you can take a big piece of pipe, like this, and swing it to stay loose and just keep going all around and make your whole body, wind up. And the weight of this really extends your arms, gets you a good swing width. You can do a lot of that, and you could just do it with a pipe that you can go get at some of the big box stores. But I would put something sticky on this, so it wouldn't slip out of your hands. I'd be careful with that. But one of the things about a stick like this, that's this long, and it really helps. I want to make sure I just do a couple of things that builds anybody's golf swing very well. I'll hold it in the middle. Notice that the handle's sticking out over here. I've got it in line with my left arm as I set up. And then I'm going to do two things in my swing. I'll give you a couple different views of this. I'll cock my wrists, and now all of a sudden, I haven't really made my arms move any. I've just kind of cocked my wrist back, and now the club, the shaft here, went from this lined up with my left arm condition here to lined up toward the target. So let's call that step one. And then step two, I'm going to keep my arms in relationship to my chest right out in front of them in the middle, and I'm just going to turn. And I turn, and I'm at the top, and I've stopped, and I can see that shaft up there. Look at it from this view. Again, this shaft right here, this pipe, lined up in line with my arm. And then, so I cock my wrist. Now you can see it's kind of in line with my shoulders and my body, my toes. I'm going to turn. Notice that it's in the same condition up there. It's still pointed at my target. So all I've really done here is step one, step two, and I've turned. Now remember, I've still got my arms out in front of my chest, and I've got my wrist cocked, and really all I've got is a really good practice drill of turning the chest, keeping my arms out, keeping the width that I have. So I've turned, and I still have a lot of width in my swing. It's good for club head speed. It's really good for that. So we've got things that we can do inside in any kind of weather to keep us going in golf. Now, there are things that you could go buy that I use here in the golf studio that I'm not necessarily going to promote product here, but I am going to tell you there are a few things that you could buy to keep yourself going in the winter. I'll go get one of them right now. I like these. I got two different sizes. One of them really makes you work out hard. That one. This one makes you work out some. But all I'm trying to do here is just swing it, and I have to turn my body and sling my arms. And I've got this fan, and it uses wind resistance. And what it does, it keeps me in shape swinging. It keeps my body active and turning. It keeps my arms slinging down. It continues to make me stronger as a player. Now, there are different sizes, as you can see. This large one here, I'll have a lot of the stronger players use this, but most human beings will use a smaller size. The reason is that because if you want to continue to do something, you have to do it at a way that you'll actually continue to do it again and again. So as you look at this one right here, this big one, this one has so much wind resistance to it that most people won't pick it up a second time. They'll buy it and then it'll just sit off in the corner because it was harder than what they wanted. But this one over here is hard enough and you'll continue to use it, and then you'll get more out of the smaller version than you will out of the bigger version because you'll do it more often. It's human nature. Here's something that we have at home. This shows us a lot about what we're doing with our hands to the club. It's a very good teacher as a tennis racket. I've got a golf shaft stuck into this tennis racket. But just to think, we put our hands on the club, we'll hold this tennis racket in the same way, and it matches up in line with my arm. And then I put my right hand on the backside. Can you imagine coming into it very straight? The tennis racket's got a kind of an oblong handle to it, and it's very easy to hold. It matches how our hands can fit. It's amazing to me how good we could all get if we could hold a golf club like a tennis racket. It would be very, very easy. The game would get a lot easier, and I think that's why the governing bodies made us use round ones, because there's a lot of skill involved in that. But I've done that. I've got a golf shaft crammed into here. So now we can test and see where the club face is going to go to. Those people who roll their hands on the way back and then they pull it through, you can see that that thing's facing way out to the right. That face is way open. I see a lot of that in people, and I make them aware of that by swinging this. And they can see exactly what they're doing because they have this mammoth club head right here where when they roll their arms on the takeaway, then they have to roll them back. And boy, that's a mess, because nobody's really very good at rolling it back in a third of a second downswing. So if you can think about this tennis racket, if you could just hold it in a way that when you took it back here, it's here, there, and back to square, it's what you'll be after. But you know, when you're not hitting a lot of golf balls inside, that's a pretty good thing to learn from, because it's got this gigantic face on it, and it makes you very aware of what you're doing, how you're practicing, what can happen. So I'd like you to take a tennis racket at home. I don't necessarily want you to put a shaft in the back end of it, but if you get so crazy, you know, to drill out the butt end of that and cut off a shaft and jam it in there, you might want to glue it. But hold on to a tennis racket and learn what it is your hands are doing so you can see it, because there's this massive face right here that'll tell you an awful lot of things. It's a great training aid. It's a great visual learning training aid. So between the ribbon to tell you where your swing is headed and what how you could alter it, and a tennis racket, you've got all the things that you could do probably at your fingertips already. So that way you wouldn't have to go out and spend a bunch of money. I want to make it so that you spend as little as possible, but get some good feedback as to where you go. Now, as it relates back to these golf balls and these foam balls, I suggest that if you're going to use some sort of backstop, like I suggested, hanging a bed sheet, or maybe you just want to hit these foam balls into a wall in your garage, okay? Make a target on the wall. Make a target on the bed sheet. Make it nothing more than a stripe. So can you imagine hanging from the top of your bed sheet a ribbon just dropped straight down right there? You could hit that, and all of a sudden you could tell at that point, did my ball start right of my ribbon, left of my ribbon, something on that stripe? Was my club face squared of the stripe? You get yourself a nice target line that way. You could use duct tape on the wall. You could make a line of duct tape right from where the ball sits, all the way on the floor, across the mat, all the way on the floor, up the wall, line it all up. You could do that with a roll of duct tape. Maybe cost you $2-3, who knows? But that could be your target line. It's cheap, it's easy, it's functional. So think in terms of what can you do in your own house, in your own garage, what can you do to make yourself practice in the wintertime indoors where you have some time. You have 15, 20 minutes a day. Pull the car out of the garage. You know, got your big space. Use it. So I wanted to talk a little bit about that today just because I know that most people are putting their clubs up. Not the people in the South. They're happy. You know, a lot of the snowbirds that we have watching our show or listening to our show, they're traveling from the North and they're headed South and their season's not ending. But for the most of us who live in the colder parts of the country, you know, it's close to Halloween. It's time now that we have to start thinking about these things. So I wanted to make this little video to talk to you a little bit about that. I just wanted to make sure that everybody out there has the thought that they have the ability to do that. If you've got a little garage space, maybe you've got a little basement space with, you know, greater than 9-foot ceilings. Yeah, maybe you can do that. Maybe you can get by with that at home. Who knows? Find a way. All the avid golfers, all the people who love this game, we all find a way. So all you need to do to get something to hit is get these small foam balls because, you know, they really don't hurt anything.